Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let's all rise for the national anthem. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you all to the third marketing convention organized by Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, Pune. We, Kashish Arora and Rishabh Javre, student managers of Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, are the master of ceremonies for today's function. The theme for this year's marketing symposium is Insights, Innovation, and Ingenuity. With great pleasure, we extend greetings to you all on behalf of Sri Balaji University, Pune. We would also like to extend our greetings to His Excellency, our Founder Chancellor, Professor Dr. Colonel A. Balasubramaniam Sir, whom we lovingly call as Bala Sir, Mrs. Thilguvathi Balasubramaniam, Chancellor SPUP, Professor B. Paramanandan Sir, Pro Chancellor, Sri Balaji University and Director of Finance, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. G. K. Shridhar Sir, Senior Director and Dean Corporate Relations, Dr. Dimple Seri Ma'am, Senior Director and Dean IT and Admissions, Dr. Biju Pillai Sir, all the directors of the institutes, deputy directors, faculty members, respected parents, and dear student managers. On this auspicious occasion, we fondly remember Professor Dr. Colonel A. Balasubramaniam Sir, Executive Director, BIMM, and Founder Chancellor of Sri Balaji University, Pune, for his vision to impart the quality education to the youth of this country.
We are fortunate to have the confirmation of eminent business leaders who will be addressing the audience. BIMM needs no introduction. BIMM is the crown jewel of Sri Balaji University, Pune. Student managers from this institute shine as bright as stars among who's who of the corporate world, thanks to the excellent education and practical guidance received by them from the institute. BIMM is the structure which rests on the pillars of 3 Ds, that is, discipline, dedication, and determination. Its roof is made up of core values of loyalty, integrity, and hard work. These values are integral part of our life. Marketing Symposium 2021 is an excellent platform for us to learn, share, and interact with some of the brightest minds from corporate world. We eagerly look forward to such kind of learning opportunities. We are proud to state that we learn and interact with at least 200 corporate stalwarts during our 2 years in Sri Balaji University, Pune. The vision and mission of our institute revolve around 3 questions. How to stand up to the expectation of students, how to stand up to the expectation of parents, and how to stand up to the expectation of industry. Our entire research, energy, focus, and prayers revolves around these 3 questions.
Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, which is the constituent institute of Sri Balaji University, Pune, is proud of our sister institute under the aegis of Sri Balaji University, namely Balaji Institute of Telecom and Management, BITM, Balaji Institute of International Business, BIIB, and Balaji Institute of Management and Human Resource Development, BIM-HRD. All the courses at Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, are specifically designed to impart and inculcate the right attitude, skill, and knowledge required by the industry for efficient performance. Our management institutes have produced very good results in terms of excellent learning environment, enlightening sessions, regular corporate interface, workshops, scientific grooming process, and multi-skilling opportunities, leading to good campus placements all over India in renowned companies. The quality of education and placements has been reflected in our rankings, not just once, but year after year.
As per Times of India survey, which was conducted in 2021, Sri Balaji University Pune is ranked among top three private universities in India. Also, the Management Institute of Sri Balaji University Pune are ranked among the top 11 B-schools in India. We are privileged to have Mr. Sandeep Pandey, the Eastern Central Region IIT Industrial as the chief guest. We all are grateful to you for your august presence. With the blessing, support, guidance, and cooperation from the corporate world, the managers of Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, are emerging as best managerial Following our tradition, start the journey of knowledge today, lighting the auspicious lamp first. Light the lamp of love in our heart, the lamp of abundance in our home, the lamp of compassion to serve others, and the lamp of knowledge to dispel the darkness of ignorance.
Ramesh sir, please play the lamp lighting video.
May we now call upon student manager Shruti Talwe to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, Shruti.
A very good morning to all the dignitaries present here. Welcome to Marketing Symposium 2021, organized by Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM Pune. I, Shruti Tarare, student manager, Balaji Institute of Modern Management, Sri Balaji University, Pune, is honored to deliver the welcome address. With the blessings of our founder chancellor, Professor Dr. Colonel A. Balasubramaniam sir, whom we lovingly call Bala sir, and on behalf of all student managers of Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, I would like to extend a warm welcome to all the dignitaries, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. G. K. Shirude sir, Pro Chancellor, and Director Finance, Professor B. Parmanand sir, Senior Director Corporate Relations, Dr. Dimple Saini madam, Senior Director and Dean IT and Admissions, Dr. Biju Pillai sir, all the directors of the institutes, deputy directors, faculty members, parents, and all my fellow student managers. Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, is the flagship institute of Sri Balaji University, Pune. BIMM has been organizing the marketing symposium, inviting thought leaders from different sectors to congregate and share their thoughts on various topics and new advancements in the industry. The symposium will reflect on how the marketing world has changed or not, and where we see it moving in the coming years. COVID-19 has catalyzed how marketers and all of us must leverage technology in all aspects of business and day-to-day life. We should always be pondering on what changes are here to stay and also understand how to tackle various challenges in the ever-changing volatile business environment. BIMM Marketing Symposium 2021 celebrates the spirit of problems are opportunities. The mantra given by our beloved Bala sir, the theme for this year's marketing symposium is insights, innovation, and ingenuity. We have a great lineup of speakers representing organizations like IFB Industries Limited, Sony Pictures Networks India, Bansal Group, Globewester, Oyo India, and Irgos India. We are sure we will have a great learning experience throughout the day from our distinguished thought leaders. The key to success is to focus on goals, not obstacles. At Sri Balaji University, Pune, we embrace change, welcome challenges, and look for opportunities in every situation to learn and grow in wisdom. On behalf of all the student managers, I wholeheartedly welcome you to the Marketing Symposium 2021, organized by Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIM. Thank you.
Thank you, Shruti. May we now request Dr. Archana Srivastav, Director BIMM, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, ma'am.
Our esteemed chief guest, Mr. Sambit Panda, Zonal Business Head, IFP, respected Bala Madam, Chancellor Sri Balaji University, Pune, respected Professor Paramanandan Balasubramanian, Sir, Pro-Chancellor Sri Balaji University, Pune, respected Dr. G.K. Shuride, Sir, Vice-Chancellor Sri Balaji University, Pune, senior directors, deans, directors, faculty members, and student managers. On this day, remembering our founder chancellor and guardian angel, Bala Sir, I welcome all of you to this marketing symposium organized by BIMM on the theme Insight, Innovation, Ingenuity. The last 1.5 years has been a trying time for everyone. Long-standing practices, ideology, thought processes have been completely disrupted by the pandemic, which has thrown a multitude of challenges for all of us. It is truly said, when times get tough, the tough get going. Businesses today have come up with unique and varied strategies, processes, and models to deal with the volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity in the emerging business scenario. Marketeers and sales personnel have been at the forefront of this innovation, ensuring that businesses are up and running and the customer is serviced with the highest quality standards, irrespective of the constraints imposed by the pandemic. The top 5 marketing trends to look for in 2021 are live video streaming. Social media platforms, of course, have paved the way for live video trend streaming. Streaming videos account for over 2/3 of all internet traffic, and it is expected to jump to 82% in the near future. Studies suggest 80% of consumers prefer watching a live video from a brand as opposed to reading a blog. And 67% of people are likely to purchase a ticket to events like a concert after watching a live stream of a similar event. Artificial intelligence tools, yes, they are being increasingly used to analyze consumer behavior. And today you have chatbots who are having conversation with your customers. Micro-influencers, another growing trend. I'm sure you're familiar with brand ambassadors and social influencers. These are people on social media who have relationship with companies and get paid to promote products on their personal profiles. Brands are reaching out to these micro-influencers because it's easier for people to relate to them. And how can we forget Generation Z? It seems over the past several years, companies have been focusing on millennials. But now it's time to put some more emphasis on younger generations as well. So Generation Z, also known as the I generation, who was born in the late 1990s to mid 20s, they are getting ready to graduate from college and soon will be entering the workforce, which also means their consumption habits will change radically. Hence, marketers should now start focusing on Gen Z as well. Consumer personalization, of course, imperative to give your customers a personalized shopping experience to increase engagement and sales. Yes, we live in interesting times, and the day ahead will acquaint us with many such path-breaking stories from the experts themselves. I'm happy to share that along with our keynote speaker, Mr. Sambit Panda, the other speakers who will be sharing their insights on this forum today are Mr. Rohan Jain, Business Head, Sony Pictures. Then we have Mr. Avinash Hasija, CEO Commercial, and Mr. Abu Asif, Chief Engineer from the Bansal Group, who will talk about a unique first-of-its-kind project in India. The post-lunch session will be a talk from Mr. Ankur Srivastav, co-founder and Vice President Globe Vista. The next session would be by Mr. Guru Shankaranarayanan, Chief Strategy Officer, OYO. And the last but not the least, a session from Mr. Ashutosh Sinha, Business Head, Argos India, who's going to again talk about a very different business model and a very critical business model. So friends, Lots to learn from this day. Welcome to this festival of knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. May we now request Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. G.K. Shridhar, sir, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, sir.
Yeah. Namo Nama. Good morning. Namaste. It's a pleasure to have a dialogue with the corporate leaders as well as with the student managers. With the divinely beautiful blessing of our founder president and founder chancellor, Professor Dr. Karnali Balasubramanian. With a very high respect, we call Bala sir. President Chancellor, Her Excellency, Srimati Tilakwati Balasubramanyam, Pro Chancellor Professor Paramananda, Deans and Directors, my fellow colleagues, my student managers, and my fraternity. Certainly, it gives a very great pleasure to me to share a few introductory words at this beautiful occasion. COVID-19, unseen pandemic situation, has created a new way of doing things. So it has created a lot of severe impact and effects. But if we consider it, the positive side of it, it has created a great transformation. And this transformation in the various sectors, various sections in the economy. Digitalization is the new name of the game. Mankind is moving towards a machine economy. And that is the most important, the impact as far as this COVID-19 is concerned. Hence, there is a need to focus on rapid reskilling, relearning, and micro-skilling is a new way to march ahead in respect of this business and business strategies. Remember that challenges come with the opportunities. Greater the challenges, more are the opportunities. This is what we have learned from our beloved Bala sir. E-commerce and development in digital technology has made a paradigm shift in respect of nature of business and its performances. In any business, customer is always at the center. Customer is always at the forefront. And that is the strength of any organization. And therefore, the decisions are also customer-centric. Many times it is said that complaining customer or most unhappy customer are the greatest source of learning to the organization, because these type of customers always give opportunity to look into the improvement in respect of the product design, the way product looks, price of the product, its utility, as well as the after sales. So the different business and marketing strategies are used in keeping the customers at forefront, recognizing always the customer's need, customer's preference, customer's priority in respect of quality of the product, cost of the product, usefulness of the product, delivery, and improving the organization's responsiveness. One has to be very smart in respect of taking care of these customers. These strategies include disruptive innovations, innovative innovations, maybe in the form of new product, as I have mentioned, a new market, new use of resources, and also the new design of the product. Changes are taking place as far as the market dynamics are concerned. So change our lenses to reach at the new horizons. And nowadays, technology-driven innovations are taking place very rapidly. After all, business is all about people. And it's a people's management whenever we talk about any business. And marketing is not the exception to that. Microsoft CEO, Satya Nadella, he has mentioned in his speech, our industry does not repeat tradition. It only repeats innovations. And it is not only repeating the innovations, but throughout in the process, product process, it always respects the innovations. And this is applicable not only to the IT, but it is applicable to all the business, all the different type of the manufacturing and service sector industries. Just to add something more, one of the economist and the management philosopher, Joseph Schumpeter, he has also pointed out in his well-known theory of innovations, profit is the result of innovations. And profit is always plays a very significant role in respect of the working of the organization. Innovative ideas, innovative methods, innovative techniques, creative thinking, innovative use of the resources plays a very crucial role as far as today's the marketing strategies are concerned. Accepting and adopting the change, modifying it timely, certainly helps to win the race. And therefore, it is always a journey in the right direction towards excellence rather than perfection. So every time, whenever we find out something new, that newness is nothing, but it is a march towards the excellence. Having said this, dear student managers, you are going to be the future corporate leaders, executives, CEOs, entrepreneurs, maybe the business leaders. And therefore, you have to wear many hats. And these hats are in the form of go-getter, innovator, strategist, achievers, and so on. Therefore, my humble request to all my student managers that listen this particular type of the thoughts of the corporate leaders very carefully. From these eminent speakers, you will get a new idea. They are the decision makers, solution providers. So feel free to have interactions with them. Understand their best innovative practices. Dear student managers, this is the weekend Saturday special knowledge feast to all of you. And whenever I am saying that this is the knowledge feast, I mean, whatever you will not find out in any book, any references, any research article, that you will listen today from these corporate leaders. And these corporate leaders are nothing, but they are the rainbow as far as the different type of the business activities are concerned. Once again, Sambit Pandaji, I welcome you on this virtual conference, virtual symposium. And the symposium is also named very perfectly by my leaders, and that is Insights, Innovation, and Ingenuity. To me, insight that is related with to look into a broader horizon with creative eyes. And that insight will give us a certain opportunity as far as value addition is concerned. And whenever we talk about the innovations, it is nothing but adding into creative values. And when we talk about the ingenuity, it is the agility, smartness, the way we take the decisions. So with these few words, once again, I wish you all the best, a great success, and a lot of takeaway from these particular corporate leaders. Have a nice day. Over to the comparers. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir. May we now invite Director of Finance and Pro-Chancellor, Sri Balaji Society, Pune, Professor B. Paramanandan, sir, to deliver the welcome address. Over to you, sir.
It's a wonderful day. Pune is having a good monsoon and the weather is nice. It's a wonderful day to start learning also. I know student, as a student, we learn every day. And sometimes it feels a little monotonous also. But the learning never stops in life. Learning is something which will keep on going on. I remember our favorite newspaper of the day, Economic Times in the morning, which we everybody reads. And the first news which I saw was the pride and the happiness of the Tata Group. 60 years, you know, 68 years they waited. 68 years they waited to get back their, you know, jewelry back, the heirloom back. 68 long years, you know, trying to get back the company which they lost to the government, and they got it back. Getting Air India, winning the bid, becoming owner again of the same company which they founded, and they have been trying to get it back for a very, very long time, and 68 long years of wait. Imagine that. And the pride is there. But remember, it's not an easy thing. Taking over a loss-making business with thousands of employees, reorganizing something which is going to be very, very difficult. But like Bala sir used to say, problems are opportunities. So there is an opportunity which is there, but there is a lot of problems also. But Tata's have, you know, taken head on, and they are trying to take on, they are taking over the group Air India, one of the pride of India. So there is a challenge, you know. When we start our day today, we must think about, you know, why we're doing it and what is our purpose. We are here to learn. And what is the best way to learn? We learn from books, we learn from teachers, we learn from workshops, we learn from a lot of, you know, quiz competitions. We learn from self-study also, but we also learn from, you know, corporate leaders. And we do a lot of interaction for one reason only, because all the knowledge which they have, nobody will have, you know, and they, that too, these are like real-time knowledge. What is happening today? That is the most important thing, to understand what is happening today and what is expected tomorrow. The books will not tell you about that. Books is nothing but about past, what happened in the past, and little bit. But the current leaders will tell you what is there. From on behalf of Sri Balaji University, it's a, you know, our proud moment to welcome Sampit Panda sir. Panda sir, welcome to our virtual campus. Once we are open very soon, of course, we're hoping we'll be opening anytime soon. And I hope you come and visit our campus and, you know, interact with the students. It is wonderful to, you know, interact. But this way, of course, is also wonderful only. And to start the day with a person like you, it is a wonderful opportunity, sir. There's one more thing which I want to say to the student is, you know, the headlines also talked about, you know, our RBI governor, you know, talking about some simple thing like, you know, taking over the movie name, Main Hoon Na. He was talking about the financial markets to relax, the companies to relax, not to worry too much. He was trying to talk about India needs to get back on the feet very fast. And the sentence was like, you know, don't worry, we are there, we are going to take care of you. And the projection is that India will be growing at a very good rate this year. India will be recovering at a good rate next year also. So that's like something like, you know, he's talking about, you know, not getting worried. And that is the most important thing in life also, not to get worried. But at the same time, COVID precautions are important. Saving life is important. Taking care of each other is important. And, you know, taking care of not only you and others is also very important. So do try to follow the protocols. Take a vaccination, you know, wherever is possible. And remember, it's not going to be easy in life. Every year, something is changing. We're talking about iPhone 13 getting launched. There is a new models are getting launched. There's Amazon sale going on. There is a Flipkart sale is going on. Everybody's talking about new models. Every company is talking about bringing new product. So the question is always, you know, what is the new thing which you're giving, going to do next year? And making innovation every year is not going to be easy. And the most important thing is, like sir was mentioning, excellence is the most important factor. How do you differentiate between yours and others? That is what is going to become important. And our three Ds of Balaji Society, discipline, dedication, and determination, they are more about, you know, focusing on excellence, on yourself. Focusing on yourself is the most important thing. Trying to improve yourself is important thing. And most important thing is also to be happy and cheerful every day in the morning. And take the life lightly, but not the issues lightly. But take life lightly and be happy. All the best. I take the opportunity again to call, welcome our chief guest of the day. We'll start with Sampit Panda, sir. Welcome, sir. Over to you, comparers.
Thank you, sir. May I now request student manager Agdis to introduce our chief guest, Sampit Panda, sir, zonal business head, West and Central Regions, IFB Industries.
Hello. Good morning, everyone. I, student manager Agdas Sheikh from Balaji Institute of Modern Management, BIMM, delegated to introduce our guest, Mr. Sampit Panda, sir. Sampit Panda, sir, is the zonal business head, West and Central Region at IFB Industry Limited, a company which is a pioneer and one of the most integrated home appliances company that provides a comprehensive suite of consumer electronic products and services across a range of product categories. Sambit sir is a true leader with an expertise of more than 24 years in the field of durable consumer electronics, telecom, and retail. Sir has worked at esteemed organizations such as Future Group India, Idea Cellular Limited, Reliance Telecom, Philips Electronics India Limited, Giardino, VIP Industries before joining the IFB Industry Limited. Sir has experience in overseeing entire business operations encompassing marketing, channel management, supply management, people management, and recently covering Pan India in future retail. Before rising to highly coveted position of a zonal business head, sir has held important positions such as national sales head, prepaid sales head, Bombay Circle prepaid sales head, Odisha Circle branch manager at Philips Electronics India, branch manager at VIP Industry Limited. Sir, we are delighted to have you with us at Shri Balaji Society Pune today. We are eagerly waiting to hear from you, sir. The digital platform is with us.
Okay. Yeah, good morning, all. I think my session starts.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, guys. I hope I'm audible and I'm clear. I'm a bit nervous also because normally, you know, we have our journey of the day starts with Zoom calls and we address our people. And in sales, no, normally that's a norm, right? So in sales, if you are on a Zoom call and if you are not on a video on, then people start questioning you. What are you doing? Where are you? So anyway, I'm not questioning any of you guys. Good morning all. Thank you very much for this opportunity to come and talk to all of you guys. Thank you, GK sir. Thank you, Commander sir. Thank you, Dr. Archana. Thank you, Bala sir. And thank you to the entire mentors of BIMM and the student fraternity. I was talking to Dr. Archana, I think a couple of days back. And there's a truth I realized on this Ganesh Chaturthi, right? So after walking for 25 years, then I realized something which I should have done long time back. So before I start, I'll tell you. So what I intend to do is that, no, I want to get into storytelling, right? So that's how I want to start. So like, tell me a fact and I'll learn. Tell me a truth and I'll believe. But tell me a story and it will live in my heart. And very ancient North American Indian proverb. Facts and data shift behaviors. They don't, we normally, in corporate world, we try to showcase a lot of data. Lot of facts, but trust me, they don't really shift the behavior, they don't shift the culture, right? Bullet points and opinions never inspire and quickly forgotten. If I show some bullet points in my PPT, if I share my opinions, they normally don't inspire people, right? And they, if it doesn't inspire people, it normally are forgotten, right? In human communication, facts talk to the mind, emotions and context warm the heart. Storytelling combines fact, emotions, and the context. So that's what I want to get into. Why this new path? On Ganesh Chaturthi, I went to a very dear friend of mine to attend Ganesh Puja, and I spoke to his daughter who just recently got into NMIS for doing an MBA, right? And I was talking, what's happening? How's life? So she says that, uncle, I had a, we know our college has just started on virtual mode and it's an online platform. We are trying to get acclimatized. And also we tend to get people coming from corporate world and talk to us. I'm like, yeah, that's good. Yeah, I think it's a great learning for you guys. And the answer that came, you know, really shocked me and shook me. She says that, yeah, it's a, when we hear the names, when we hear their profiles, you know, we really know that they are the great leaders. But they come and show PPTs and they talk about certain facts. They talk about certain things. That's something possibly, doesn't inspire me. And then I came back. And then I thought, what am I doing? I am also doing the same thing. And I get an opportunity to go show some PPTs, talk to people, connect with them. People possibly, get, I transfer my energy to the entire audience and audience really get energized. But as soon as I am off platform, the energy level comes down, right? And it doesn't really inspire the audience. If I can't inspire the audience, if I can't leave behind certain, certain important aspects of life journey, then I will not be able to create a kind of a difference, or I can't be able to create a kind of touch to the audience, right? So that's where I decided not to get any PPT. So if you guys are expecting me to show a PPT, extremely sorry. So there's no PPT. You have to bear with me for next 1 hour with my video, and I'll just talk, right? And it's a very impromptu talking that I'm going to do. Maybe as been told, if I get a chance to come and interact with you guys when those colleges open up, maybe I can really share a lot of learnings. But today I'm going to talk impromptu. I hope that's okay with all of you guys, right? I'm here to try and inspire all of you guys, because I can see myself 25 years back in 1995, the same position when I also was just coming out of my management issue and wanted to get into the corporate world, right? 1995 was not in particular a great year to get into corporate world, because that's the year when the placements become an issue, right? And that's how my tough journey started. I thought I've done my MBA, now I'll come out and then get into a job and then get some decent salary, and being a bachelor, I'll have a good life to lead and blah, blah, blah. And nothing such happened, right? The placement was completely dry. So we had to take, few of my friends took the train to Delhi and few of my friends took the train to Bombay. And that's how I went to Delhi and started my journey. So I'll just take you through few key points, right? Which I think you students who are going to join the corporate world are going to go through the similar journey, I'm sure. And the similar journey, it's very important at your age to differentiate between what is that you want and what is that you are being offered, right? So the first point to all of you guys, which I did for myself when I went for my interview after going to Delhi after 3 months of trying to work for a DSA. I don't know, most of you guys know DSA or not. DSA is basically a direct selling agency. So I joined a Citibank direct selling agency just to ensure that I can take care of my stay in Delhi. So it was basically a distributor of Citibank where I went and started selling financials to the customers, right? But that was a very stopgap arrangement I did, because I didn't want to get into that. Choice to be made in early part of one's career is very, very important. You'll have placements coming to your institute. But here comes your choice. Look for the job you are passionate about. What is that you exactly want to do? You'll find that a lot of people go by the badge value. A lot of people go by the organization value, right? It's important to get into a good organization, because that's where you start learning, right? Whatever you have learned in your 2 years of MBA program in BIMM, and when you go into and jump into a real world, you'll find that a lot of things come crashing down, and your learnings, you don't start using it on day one or the first minute. There are a lot of other things you start using as a skill set. Not all those things that you have learned, right? So it's important to make a good choice and be very passionate about what is that you want to do. Once you find what is the most passionate about and get that extra bit of spring to his step, that's the first learning. Why I'm saying this? When I got a chance to be interviewed by Sharp India, by Blow Plus Limited, and by I think one more company, right? So I don't remember the company. So three companies, and I got selected in Sharp India, and I got selected in Blowplast. That time, those days, 1995, we never had Googles to try and figure out, you know, what are the great strength of each of the companies. But when I was walking in the market, I happened to go to a few of the luggage counters in Delhi. And those counters reflect the value system of the organization, trust me. And I had a window when I could have gone for interview after 3 days. So in those 3 days, I really went to a store, tried to figure out what are the values of each of the company, the Sharp India and Kalyani Sharp, and then Blowplast VIP Luggage. And those days, VIP Luggage and Asian Paints used to be the founding, or it can say that it used to be the best place to work for somebody who's coming in to start his or her career. The learning that I got from Blowplast Limited was immense. And today, what I am today largely goes because the kind of grind I went through Blowplast, the kind of value system was been taught to me, really helped me. So my humble request to all you guys, when the placement comes, don't go by the badge value, don't go by the brand. Try to see what are you passionate about, what is that exactly you want to do. If you can figure out that, I'm sure you will land into the best of the place where you want to really learn and go ahead, right? It's very important also to introduce yourself, right? In sales or in marketing, we interact very frequently with so many people. Huh? It can be your seniors, it can be your colleagues, it can be your channel partners. It's not about your credentials. It's not about where are you from. It's not about Sambit from Regional College of Management, Utkal University, with Blowplast Limited for 8 years. That's one part of the credentials of Sambit, right? But when I'm going to introduce myself, when I'm talking to somebody, it has to be more about the character also. So as youngsters, whenever you are, we normally get swayed away, right? I am Lucknow, I am Ahmedabad, IIT Kharagpur is something that takes away 90% of my credibility, right? And that's what I try to stress, because that's what I believe, that I am a IIT Bombay, I am Ahmedabad pass out candidate. That's fair. But what is there in store for the person who is hearing you, who is trying to know you? You have to show your character, right? What do you mean by character? It's about your, can the other person trust you? Can when you talk, he's been able to figure out the trust factor in you? Does he figure out that he's a guy who is all about detailing, right? Does he find out that he's a guy who really is very creative? If I say that I'm Sambit from Utkal University, worked for the first year, 8 years in Blowplast Limited, and I really walked into the kind of stock management. I went into the detailing of the rate of return on investment for my channel partners. I was so very serious about ensuring that my network expands. So if I can get into those kind of detailings, then it brings the credibility and the character of mine. And then the credibility becomes very, very strong. So it's very important that whoever you are interacting with in your next journey, or when you get into a corporate world, it's important to bring in your credentials with the character, right? It's very, very important. The mix of credentials and it is very, very important, right? Now, as you start the journey, right? I'll tell you one story. I talk about as gathering the gold dust. This I heard from one of the very great speaker, and he's a storyteller actually, right? In the last 15 days, I've gone through some 100 stories, right? Indranil Chakravarti, whenever you get time, please go through the videos. He talks and introduces you to the big leaders. So now I was hearing him once. He talks about gathering gold dust. And then I went back and tried to figure out what is that I have actually gathered as a gold dust. So when I was a management trainee, I joined Blowplast. I was told to go to one remote village in Odisha. And I went with my senior, who was a sales officer there, right? So he was talking to somebody, and then to the manager of the store. And I got some time. I was talking to the shop owner's son. And I was talking to him and saying that, buddy, I find that you are discounting and selling at a very low margin. Why are you selling at a low margin? Why are you eroding away your profits? You know what that small kid who is just from a business family, small shop. He's not even a graduate, I believe. He told me, sir, you have got me wrong. You got us wrong. I know I'm wholesaling my products, but I'm making a retention of only 0.5%. Doesn't matter, because you give me a 15 days credit and I'm doing a business on cash and I rotate this cash. It's almost 100 times in a year. So 0.5%, when I look at 100 times in a year, it's a huge rate of return on investment. So I don't want to look at absolute value that I'm earning. I'm looking at how fast I'm rotating my money. And see, at that age, the guy who is not even a graduate taught me a very important lesson in life, that don't go and build an opinion. Because when you went to your company, somebody told you that, no, that products should not be discounted, the dealers should make good margin, and if they make good margin, they really make, you know, they are committed to you. No, not necessary, because it's not applicable to everybody, every channel, in every market, right? So this is one golden dust that I carried and I learned during the early part of my career. And trust me, when I started walking in the field, this always came back to me. Whenever I was trying to go slightly, you know, into a bookish kind of thoughts, or a classroom kind of thoughts, these thoughts really came up and said, yeah, this guy is doing something which is adding value to his business. So if he's adding value to his business, he is going to add value to my business. And I am there only to add value to my business and make him happy. Right? One important thing, if you look at, no, again, I'll tell you, I went with my boss when I was working with Idea Cellular Limited. That one time I was prepared sales head after working for almost 18 years, right? So 18 years of experience, I worked in different market in different capacities. And then when I went to the market with my head of sales, I saw a very peculiar thing that he did, right? So when you go to the market, you have the promoters, right? People who sell. So we thought that let us go and talk to some of the promoters. Now, these are the guys who are the interface between the consumer and the company. They are the ideologies of the company, right? So he told somebody, can we go and talk to him and figure out that what we discuss is been translated to him? So we went there. My general manager, branch manager was there. My ASM was there. My executive was there, right? And this promoter was there. He is the most important filler for any organization. He started asking about certain policies, processes, incentive. So we thought, what is going to motivate a promoter? This is incentive, right? Because they are only 8,000 rupees paid guys. They earn incentive which makes them live their dream, right? So we thought, why not ask them the incentive and ask them if they know the incentive, do they know how to earn the incentive? See, in colleges, no, they don't teach any of these things, right? In colleges, in our boardrooms, we make all those strategies. We make the best of the product. We really make best of the product for the consumers. We make the best of the incentive for the sales guys. But we seldom spend time to understand how do we translate it to the end user. Because he's the guy who is going to translate it into end sales. And what we figure out that day is that the guy knows everything, but doesn't know how to earn that incentive. So if I say, I'll give you 5,000 rupees, he says, I'm very happy, sir, but he doesn't know how, because he has not earned 5,000 rupees. Forget 5,000 rupees, 1,000 rupees for last 5 months. So whatever you do doesn't have, and then you say that your executive is not productive, your ASM is not working. But when we went to the field, we found that the promoter knows everything. That means my executive has done a bit of his, whatever he was supposed to do. So here my sales head, what did he do? You know, he went and told, if you have to earn 5,000 rupees, what is that you have to do throughout the day of 8 hours? And for that particular day, we just did what this guy is supposed to do in the market, in the field, when he's interacting with the consumer. And then he told, now I've done it. Have you understood it? Now please do it for me once. Because most of the time we go and just communicate and think that you've understood, he or she has understood, but not necessarily the truth. The next day when the person was asked to do again, and we spent in that village 2 days, trust me, that guy will taught him how to earn money. If that guy understood how to earn money, your numbers are given. But we try to create those structures, we try to create the communication, but we seldom spend time by playing the role of a soldier. In American, one of the American general was saying, if you don't lead the life of a soldier, then you can't lead an entire group. You have to lead the life of the soldier if you want to really lead the group, right? So that's one learning I had, when I was walking after 18 years of my job. One very important thing for all of you guys, because I also have gone through, although I might not be from as premium institute as you guys are very fortunate and you guys are really informed in this digital world. And with such a great mentors that you guys have. In our days in 1995, we used to have professors who used to give us those sessions. We used to get some exposure because being from Odisha, Bhubaneswar, those exposures were limited in compared to what you get in Bombay or Pune or Delhi. So, but I happened to hear one of the leader called, I don't know how many people know him. You should hear him whenever you get a chance. Mr. Shiv Kumar. He's a true leader by himself, right? If you hear one of the videos, no, I happened to work with him in Philips. And I was under him for a 1 month induction. That's my biggest fortune that I could have really gathered in my last 25 years, other than the money that I could have made, the wealth I could have made. This Mr. Shiv Kumar was telling that, Sambit, most of the time, when such millennials like you guys come, management trainees with a huge IQ level, right? You guys are the best of the intellects. When you come, and then as managers, what do? We quickly try to get into a prescriptive mode. We try to say you what is that you are supposed to do. We don't create an environment where you start experiencing things. Unless you experience things, no, your learnings are not going to go up. If I really want my team to really do well, I really don't need to be very prescriptive. In corporate world, managers like us, 99.9 times we try to be prescriptive. We try to tell people, do this. This is how you can do it. No. Because there are people who have come from different background, with different cultures. They have come with the best of the intellects, best of the IQ levels. They can really deliver. There is a remote chance that they are not going to deliver. But we have to create an environment where these guys can go and experience, right? So tomorrow when you start your journey and you become a middle manager, or tomorrow you start leading people, please keep this in mind. I have learned this in 2003 and I have stopped since 2003. Because 2003 is when I got into a managerial role, when I was handling a big branch and a big set of people. And I realized that whenever I try to become prescriptive, no, I tend to lose the confidence of the youngster. So whenever you become a manager in going forward in your life, maybe 5 years down the line, please ensure that you don't get into a quickly jump into a prescriptive mode because of your credentials. Try to bring in those credentials and the credibility. Basically, how you create the trust factor. How do you really dirty your hand? How do you make him understand and allow him to make mistakes? There is always, as managers, I was been told, when I become a branch manager in Loplas in MP, so there used to be a budget, right? And I was very pretty new, and came the marriage season, right? In marriage season, we try to disproportionately spend our budgets in marketing activities, right? So one of my senior bosses from head office called me up, Sambit, you are doing it for the first time, so I hope you have done all your homework and you know where you're spending your money so that you get the best output out of this entire money that you're spending. So I never had any other option but to say yes, I have understood it, sir. There came my branch, my reporting boss. He told Sambit, assuming I have given you 10 crores to spend, out of those 10 crores, 1 crore I have provisioned as your learning experience, a mistake that you're going to make and you're going to spend that 1 crore, which is not going to give me that value. So please factor in all your plans, a learning experience cost, because very, very rarely you'll find people who are very passionate will not make mistakes. But as a manager, if I don't provision that, there where the unhealthy discussion starts, there where I push my team, there where the team get demotivated, right? So always in your life, even in your own life, try to keep a provision of learning value. There is a cost to every learning. It doesn't come free, right? So this very important learning for me in my last 25 years, where I started provisioning. So whenever I talk to my people, I know they'll make a mistake. I keep a provision for that, so that when I review their performance, if this factor is brought into the discussion, trust me, the discussions get to different level altogether. And there where the productivity starts coming in, right? See, if I say I'm a manager, right? And there is somebody called entrepreneur. This learning came when I worked with Kishore Bihaniji, right? It's very, very important. In your career, always look for working for an entrepreneur. It's a huge learning. It's not easy to work for an entrepreneur. I'm telling you, it's not easy to work an entrepreneur. The stress level working for even a company by the corporate world also is not easy. But working for an entrepreneur gives you a lot of insight in life. So I'll give you one example. In Odisha, I think people from Odisha will be able to relate. In Odisha, you guys would have gone to Big Bazaar or Central for your shoppings, right? In Big Bazaar, we used to celebrate those big days, right? 26th January, 15th August, when we find so much of crowd in the store, and we are supposed to be there in the store to experience the customer behavior. Mr. Kishore Biani happened to come to the store in Odisha, and there was so much of crowd in the store. And he was talking to all of us. I was based out of Bombay, so I happened to go to the health store in Odisha. It was in Sambalpur, right? In Sambalpur store, I was standing there having my cup of tea, and Kishore Bihaniji came. So we were all alert, but we had so many customers to handle. And then he called all of us, says that, guys, tell me, when you have so many customers, there has to be a bit of learning for all of us, right? So what is that we are going to learn today, which is going to add to our business value? So everybody starts saying, sir, we will try to give the best of the service. We'll ensure the checkouts are the fastest. We'll ensure that nobody goes without getting a product in ourselves. So these are the basic language all of us spoke, right? Do you know what he told us? He told, see, Sambit. And he called the store manager and the general manager. Let all of us just wait near the counter and watch the customers. There were ladies in this summer of Odisha wearing socks. In Odisha, ladies wearing socks is a style statement. Trust me, this is a style statement in a tier 2, tier 3 cities of Odisha, right? Even in summer, you normally wear socks when it is a winter day, right? You try to safeguard your skin. In Odisha, people wear on sandals or whatever they wear socks. Now he told me, somebody, see, if it is a style statement and these ladies are wearing socks, can you show me where is my socks in the store? See, the next moment, we got every counter packed with socks and our sock sales really multiplied. See, this is what is the thought an entrepreneur brings in. A manager can never bring in this thought, because manager always works with a resource. A resource been given to him. Aapko maine 10 crore ka budget de diya. 50 crore ka sale chahiye. Yes, sir. Kal aapka 10 crore, I'll bring it down to 9 crore. What is going to happen, Sambit? Sir, I'll try to do 50 crores, but I think I might end up at 40 crores. That is, ambition is directly linked to the resource, right? This is a manager mindset. But the entrepreneur mindset is not ambition is equal to resource. His mindset is ambition is always much, much greater than resource. There's a disbalance. Huh? If ambition is equal to resource, then we become a manager. If ambition is much, much bigger than the resource, that means you have less and less is more. Huh? You guys would have learned it and heard from a lot of leaders. Less is more. And see, here, this guy has added value. And that's a huge learning. In my 25 years, this is a learning. And 4 years working for this entrepreneur was an eye-opener. Huh? When you can't think is where he start thinking. Because for an entrepreneur mindset. So you guys can become entrepreneur tomorrow. I'm sure you millennials will definitely try to become entrepreneur tomorrow, right? If you want to become entrepreneur, always remember that ambition is not equal to resource. Your ambition has to be much, much bigger than resource. You will always have the constraint of resource. There where an entrepreneur brings in the value. And that's how Kishore Biyani is what Kishore Biyani today. Unfortunately, Future Group has gone through a tough time, but all of us know by heart that he's one of the pioneer in retail, in modern retail, right? I think I've been able to communicate to you guys. I'm just speaking out of my heart. So whatever. So I've not prepared anything. I'm just going through a flow. So it is always important to have a mismatch of ambition and your resource, right? I was talking to one of my in Idea Cellular Limited. I was talking to my CEO, right? It was on a Sunday morning. He called me. He wanted to review certain things, and he called me. But this is a very important learning. Please just keep it with you. I'm telling you this. These are the gems of my dust that I golden dust that I've gathered. So he asked me a question, and as any manager know, we are always eager. If we know one, we are scared when you go to the CEO because on a Sunday he has called me. I don't know what he's going to ask me. So I go through humongous amount of data, right? So I went there with all my data in my mind. Everything is all jam-packed and everything is cluttered there, right? I don't know what he's going to ask and whether I'm able to answer, but I'll be able to answer it. He asked me a very simple question and I answered him, right? I answered him. He didn't call me to review me. The CEO didn't call on a Sunday. He didn't want to invest his time to review me. He also has a family, right? He possibly saw that I was a part of their lead program where I was a fast tracker, so I was part of the lead program, right? He told, let me have a chat with Sambit. So he created a situation where I was under stress, right? He asked me a very simple, very simple question. I answered a very obvious answer I gave. He told me, Sambit, have you a cup of tea? So today there's no review. Only from this question that I asked and the answer you gave is what I want to spend some time in. We normally, as managers, always jump to give the obvious answers. If you want to become a true champion, you should first understand what is the question and is the question is so obvious answer that you have to give. A leader always asks a question where you are expected to answer two level up. Please understand, if a leader asks you a question, you only get a chance to talk to senior people in your company when you go to join a company. And all of a sudden, you don't get chance in maybe once in one year, you get a chance to meet your top bosses, right? And the CEO all of a sudden asks, Kashish, can you tell me something? And don't jump to answer the obvious answer. That's the opportunity lost. Because those few seconds when you answer, no, he judges that, are you really ready for the next level? But he expects and questions you from that point of view. And 100% time you'll find that we jump to answering the obvious answer. We should not do that. Whenever you get such opportunity, I'm not saying that on an everyday basis, your immediate boss asks you something, then you get in two level up, doesn't work out, right? So don't try to replicate everywhere. But whenever you get a chance to talk to anybody who is very, very senior in the hierarchy, and you get a chance to talk to him once in a year, a question comes, take a deep breath and answer two level up. Because two level up is what is going to take your career up. Right? So this is one learning I had when I had a Sunday cup of tea with my CEO in Idea Cellular Limited, which was not very late, but in 2013 when I was in Bombay. Right. So guys, you can see a 25 years experienced guy and still learning. And now that I've come to IIP, is a huge bit of learning for me. Right. One important point which I would like to bring into your, you guys would have heard about Stephen Covey, right? Stephen Covey is a genius. All of you guys would have read his books. I'm sure you would have read his books. And today nobody reads books, but you would have gone through the videos and all those podcasts and all. Very important point. Every executive, every manager, every management trainee makes a mistake is we don't differentiate between important and urgent. Right? You would have heard this. You would have read this. I'll give an example. Important and urgent is a very, 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 it's a very simple, important and urgent. If I ask you guys, what is important, what is urgent? Maybe again, we'll get into a very obvious answer of giving the literal meaning of important and urgent. But think again, you don't have to answer me the obvious meaning. I know what is important and urgent. I wanted two level up answer, right? So now here, most of the time you'll find, even in your today's life, when you are going through your management course, there's something called important, there's something called urgent, right? There are some kids who would be focusing largely on important things. And there will be a lot of your batchmates who will be focusing on the urgent things, right? I have to finish my today's assignment. I have to go to the college. I have to attend this lecture. I have to come back and make a note. These are very, very, these are urgent, right? I'm not saying these are important. These are also equally important. But you need to prioritize things, right? Urgent is something which is going to build your character. It's going to build your career. It's going to build yourself. And you have to disproportionately time you have to give. But you have got 24 hours in life. Out of which 6 hours you have to sleep. And then maybe another 2 hours for doing all your basic things. So you are left with whatever little time. And if the entire day, so you go back today and see, just keep writing from morning 9 o'clock. What are you doing for the entire day? Do it for 7 days. You'll find that most of the time you are spending time doing urgent things, not important. Urgent things are like taking calls. If my mom calls me, it's an important call, right? I will take a call. But can I align myself with a mom that I call when I need my mom to speak to, or she knows when she should speak to me? So talking to mom is very, very important. It's a very emotional bond, right? I can't ignore my mom. But then I need to work out my things, my priorities, so that my mom also has been heard and I also feel that happiness, right? I don't ignore her. But then you need to very, very... So there comes a video. I don't know which you guys would have seen about the big rocks. I don't know how many people have seen. Kasis, have you heard about it? Big rocks? I could see a few people on the screen, so I'm asking the name. Sorry. Yeah. So the big rocks. Big rocks are... Please go and see the video of big rocks if you have not seen it. It's a live learning video by Stephen Covey. Big rocks. He says that, no, if you want to put it in a practical life, you can do it. He says, if you have not seen the video, I'll just take 2 minutes. He says that he puts some big rocks and a lot of pebbles, right, in a glass jar. And he says, I want everything to be put into the jar. And you know, the pebbles itself is going to take the 90% space of the jar. How do you put everything? And in big rocks, what, if I've been asked, I go there, I try to squeeze in some of the rocks and then try to fill as much as possible, because I know everything is not going to go in. That's what I have been thinking, right? When the exercise is over and you see the rocks which are left out, you'll find, as a human being, we try to get the biggest rock in first, correct? And we leave the smallest rock. When I picked up the small rock, it talked about my health. When I picked up a small rock, it talked about my family balance. When I picked up, it spoke about a lot of other things which are qualitative to your life. So you do everything, you filled up the jar, you got all the small pebbles, you could have left some of the small pebbles out. Doesn't matter, because those are urgent, they are not important. But you can't ignore your important part called the health of yourself or your family, right? So please, if you're not seen, look at this. So in corporate life, today also, trust me, our people falter at prioritizing things. As managers, you will always be under tremendous amount of stress to do all those urgent things. Your manager will be chasing you like mad. Here comes your intellect, here comes your priorities, where you have to decide what is important for me, what is urgent for me. As managers, you have people who are reporting to you, right? Can some of the urgent thing be delegated to them? Here comes your delegating skills. A lot of managers don't know how to delegate. They think that they can do everything and they can only do everything, right? If you do that, you'll keep working till 10 o'clock in the night, come back home, keep causing the company, keep spoiling your health, and then you'll keep leaving behind a lot of those important rocks. Just take 1 second. So, if you look at the corporate journey, you know, so as I told you, these are few things which possibly you will learn out of your experience, right? And it's very, very important for you to be successful is that you have to say no to people. Even if it is your boss, doesn't matter. If your boss is asking you to do something which is not part of your important agenda, you have to please make a list of things that are important. Important is always a long-term goal. It is not a short-term goal, right? Urgent is now, just now. So you'll find a lot of managers know will be 100% all males red. There'll be managers you'll find there are some males which are not red. So whom do you call is the most effective manager? Is the guy who has read all the males, or is the guy who has possibly read 70% of the males and left out 30% of the males? you'll find that the guy who has left 30% of the mails are far more effective because he knows there are some routine mails that are coming in which he can park and do it whenever he gets free time. Clearing all your mails doesn't make you the most effective and efficient leader, right? Now coming, so I think also I'll try to take you guys through a post-COVID scenario also, right? And then I've got one small viewpoint of mine which I like to share with closing my part of communication, then I'll open the forum for you guys. See, now in current time, now with this pandemic coming in, one, this sales force, I think you guys are all protected, right? Your college all protected. You guys don't really want to step out. Just think about people in the field. Think about the sales guys. Think about your micro oven has gone wrong and you want the micro oven to repair. There's somebody coming to your house to do it, right? The kind of exposure that guy is putting and the kind of risk that guy is putting to go to your house to repair the micro. If he doesn't do that, you are going to suffer and so is the brand. Correct? So in this pandemic, it's very important that you keep hearing your customers, right? It's a very, very strong value system of IP I'll try to share with you guys. They say, keep talking to your customers. If you're talking to your customer doesn't talk to the competition. If I'm talking to Monesh Sharma, is my customer, I am sure if I communicating with him about his service, about his happiness, about using my product, I am sure Monesh will never think about a LG or a Samsung in the world. It's a strong value system. Keep talking to your customers. Customers can be the end user. Customer can be your executives also. Keep talking to your executives as a manager. If you keep talking to executive will be not looking at the job portal and looking at interviews in the other part of the country. Right? Keep engaging with your people, right? So this is again one very important learning and a value system that we have learned. I have learned in last 1 year after joining IIT. Now, post-pandemic, things have evolved. In fact, the businesses for our industry has gone up. A lot of industries are doing well. It's a myth that business has not taken off. Business has taken off because people like me, maybe like Sheikh or Mones, have started using microwave at home to flaunt their cooking skills, right? Now that all of a sudden you saw that your maid is no longer there and your maid was using a unrepaired washing machine because she's a maid. So she can go through all the pain to wash. Why should I change my machine? All of a sudden you have to wash your clothes. Now you find that the machine is not working. So you need to buy a machine. So the sales has gone up. The business has gone up. People have started going to the market. But we are very, very careful when we are working in the market. We are trying to ensure that each of our touch points are vaccinated. And each of these guys are given all those support in case something goes wrong. For IAP in Goa, we have hired a resort where any factory labor, for God forbid, for some reason gets impacted, he's been shifted to that resort. So the company takes care of that employee, that don't worry. You are important. You have to be in the field. But even if you're in the field, if something goes wrong, I'm there for you with a doctor, with an environment where you are safe. That culture is very important. It's very, very important to build a culture. A lot of good companies fail because they don't tend to build a good culture. It's all about building a good, passionate culture, right? And there are certain trends in sales, which is very, very important for all of you guys to understand. In our time, earlier days, a lot of number sales that used to do used to be transactional, right? Now, each sales is no longer transactional. It has moved from transactional to relationship. So every customer I touch, every channel partner I touch, is no longer a transaction. I go, aapka order de dijiye, aapko ye paisa mil gaya, aapko ye margin mil gaya. No. It's all about relationship. It's all about adding value to that transaction. So no longer transaction, that plain transaction, they have become relationship. This is a new trend that is emerging, right? There is no longer called individual. Earlier days, they used to say, maine kar diya. As long as I am there, don't worry. It's all about team now. Millennials, if you don't value their time, you don't value their learnings, these guys are not going to be with you. That's for granted. Right? So it's all about team. You have to really ensure that you build a team. You are no longer what you are. You are better known for your team, not for what you are, right? there is called sales volume, right? We used to be like measured by the volume. कितना कितना पेटी आपने बेचा, कितना हैंडसेट आपने बेचा, कितना लगेज बेचा. Now it's all about productivity. Sambit, you today are supposed to visit 5 outlets. How many outlets have you visited? Each outlet earlier used to ask, अच्छा आपको 1 लाख करना था, आपने 1 लाख का ऑर्डर लेके आया. मैंने बोला हाँ लाया सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच, गुड. Now the question is that Sambit, you are supposed to go to 5 outlets. In 5 outlets there is a market share. You are supposed to get certain value business there. Forget about 1 lakh. Have you done that? So see, the transaction of 1 lakh has now moved to productivity. So now, as managers, you guys need to remember that you are getting into a phase where it is all about productivity of your time spent, resource spent, right? It's not about management anymore. It's all about leadership. It's not about trying to be a good manager. It's trying to be a good leader. Leader who can really bring in that culture and create that passion within the team, right? It's all about, it's no longer about administration, like कितने लोगों ने चाय पिया, चाय 9 बजे आए कि नहीं, आप आके आते हो कि नहीं. It's not about that anymore. Organization is not going through. Now in pandemic, who looks at who is coming at what time? It's all about empowerment. Do my employees know, even if they come 1 hour late, not an issue. Do they know what exactly they're supposed to do, and they know what are the resources with them? So from administrative part in this pandemic, things have moved toward empowerment, because nobody is able to see each other now. A lot of managers are sitting at home and working from home, right? Earlier, we used to be with our people 365 days. Now we can't go, we can't travel. There are a lot of restrictions, right? So how do you measure your people effectiveness? You have to trust them, give them the right direction, and then start looking at their, and you have to empower them, right? And it is no longer local. Huh? If I need to, I've got a sister in Bhubaneswar, and I need to buy a good dinner for her. Earlier days, it was not possible. You have to call up somebody, tell him that Dada, thoda sa mera sister ki yahan pe, can you pack something and send it? And then you are taking somebody's time. Today, sitting at Bombay, I can go to Zomato or Swiggy and order everything, and I can make my sister very happy and very surprised, right? So it's no longer that you are in a local kind of domain, right? You are far beyond that. So I think this is a very important transition that has already happened. Industry is doing well. It is all digital now. Earlier, we used to do a lot of paper ads, hoardings. Now you can find a lot of hoardings. When you go to Lonawala to Pune to Bombay, you'll find a lot of hoardings blank, because everything has moved into digital platform, right? They're all on Insta and all Facebook that you get, everything that is covered, right? So a lot of things have become digital now. So the typical spending of your marketing budget on those traditional marketing activities has now moved to more of the spending where your customers are, right? Companies have started getting the youngsters of the house, the kids of the house, as the key decision maker in every aspect we are now looking at. Because these are, if I don't know, like maybe your parents want to go out for dinner, you now guys have grown up, so I don't know how much you must be talking to your parents nowadays. But just think about 10 years back. Not you don't think about 10 years back. Think about I don't know who all are married. I'm married. So if I today decide to go out for lunch or dinner, it is my son who decides where should I go. Oh, quickly get into the into handset. Sir, Papa, here we should go. You get the best of Chinese. They know exactly where we need to go, and they are the guys who make decisions today, not me, not my wife. Gone are those days, right? So in your entire activities of marketing, you need to remain focused. Who are your opinion leaders? Who are your influencers? Correct? My last part, which I strongly believe, as a sales guy or as a executive, as a manager, as a leader, I don't know if you guys would have heard about 212 degree. Have you heard about have you seen the video 212 degree? If you're not seen, I'll request you guys to go and see this, watch this video, 5-minute video. 212, 211 degree, they say the water boils, right? The water gets heat. The water is hot, right? When it is 211 degree. And 212 degree, the water becomes, it starts boiling and it starts generating steam. So what is so big about this steam getting generated 212 degree? Just go back and look at the locomotives which used to be driven by the steam engines. This steam moves a locomotive. There can't be anything tougher than moving a locomotive, right? This 212 degree, that means from 211 to 212 degree, can move as big a humongous machine like a locomotive, right? That 1 degree is the effort that all of us either put or we don't put. In a lot of cases, people seldom put that 1 degree effort. This 1 degree efforts differentiate between a good and a great. If you see some of the leaders who are great, they are great because they put that 1 degree effort. So they call it 1 degree effort. So it's a 212 water gets hot and 212 water starts boiling and they generate steam and the steam moves the locomotive. If you guys want to move your locomotive, if you want to move your career, you want to really see yourself a great leader, please, please bring in that 1 degree. Now I leave it to you guys to think, what is that 1 degree for you at this stage of life? The 1 degree keep changing, right? So look at what is that you are doing for that 1 degree. That 1 degree effort is going to make you from a good to great. Huh? So it's good to hear. Read those books called Good to Great. But that good to great can only happen when that 1 degree comes in as effort, right, from all of us. So that's all from me, friends. I think I've been able to communicate to you guys with my life experiences. And I hope I've not bored you guys. Because I got a shock on Ganesh Chaturthi when my friend's daughter said that, no, she was hardly looking at what the gentleman was talking. So due respect to the gentleman, I think I didn't bore you guys. Thank you. Thank you very much. And it's open. If you guys want to ask anything, you can ask.
Thank you, sir. May I now request Dr. Archana Srivastava, Director BIMM, to take on the Q&A session.
So first of all, Sambit sir, thank you so much. And
Archana, I hope I didn't disappoint you by not showing a PPT. Yeah?
Not at all, sir. Not at all. I think your rich experience was talking and your friendly style. I think everyone's connected with you. And we have learned a lot during this session, sir.
Thank you.
Personally, sir, I can't identify more with your thought that 1 degree makes a difference. Correct. That 1 degree definitely makes a difference between ordinary and extraordinary. And we should always strive to be that extraordinary. Sir, if you allow, sir, can we take up a few questions from the students, sir?
Please. I'll love to give that two-level up answer.
Sure, sir. So the first one is from Avik Chakravarti. And okay. He says, one of the core values of IFB says, communicate daily with your customers. If they are talking to you, they can't be talking to the competitor. So in this intensely competitive world of FMCD, how do you communicate the value proposition of IFB to your customers?
Good question. I think I touched on this value. Good that he's picked it up. It's a very important, it's a statement, right? But this statement is not about, again, it's not about the literal meaning of this statement, right? It's not about the consumer to start with. It's about your people to start with. So what this is the internal value system. The consumer doesn't know about it, right? So it says that, Sambit, if you are going interacting with Archana, you need to understand what is that Archana is expecting from IFB, right? How you are going to communicate in this COVID time, how are you going to ensure the protocol, right? And most importantly, do we need to wait for Dr. Archana to call up, or can we be proactive in terms of trying to figure out that if everything is going well in a house, is the machine doing well? Because today we all know if something goes wrong with the machine, what kind of stress it can give to any of the housewives or the running member of the house. So it first talks about our internal value system, that please ensure that you are talking to your customers. You are reaching out to your customers in a sense that, see, I'll give you an example, not about taking any name of the brands. So there are brands which have got the best of the services. I'll leave it to you guys to figure out. There are brands who give the best of the services. There are brands which possibly gives you a very, very average service, right? Because see, in today's time, no, nobody can guarantee you a 100% service in a given tat, right? Because of so many other obvious reasons. Now, my question to all of you guys, do the customer need so many services for the product? So a brand giving you the best of the service in terms of being on the job. My first question that, do I get in many calls? Do my customer even need to make me a call in once in 3 years or 4 years? So we ensure that our machines are the best of the machines. We really ensure that we are the best in the technology. We are the pioneers. We make our people keep talking. So my promoters, we have got 5,000 promoters across the stores. You go to the store, you find somebody selling you some product, right? They're the brand promoters. These promoters talk to every customer. There are each promoter talk to 30 customers of our base. If we got 6 million customers, 5,000 promoters, they reach out to every customer, 30 customers every day, talking to them. What are they supposed to talk? It's been scripted to them. So they talk to them, try to reach out if there is any issue in the machines, be proactive. And if it is there, then try to help the customer to solve the issue. If it is not there, also the same customer might be needing something else. Why the customer need to go to competition? I can say, no, I got a microwave oven. Madam, I've introduced a dryer. I've introduced a dishwasher. So that's where you are reaching out to customer without getting into a hoarding or a paper ad. So the best way to reach out to customer is keep talking to a customer. And who best can do it? The seller who has sold to the customer. So we don't communicate to the, I don't call the customers. The seller, if I have sold Archana ji, she came to my store, she bought from Sambit. I'm sure she is going to trust Sambit far more than anybody else, even far more than the brand. Because her experience with Sambit has made her buy that product. Although the brand and the product would have played a role. So I think I've been able to answer your question. So it's all about reaching out to a customer and talking to customers, showing your intent and building that trust.
Right, sir. So trust factor is the key here. So the second question is from Shruti Jain. And she says, IFP has a lot of firsts to its name. India's first front-loading washing machine, India's first 100% cloth dryer, India's first dishwasher, and many more. So how important is innovation at IFP to stay ahead of the competition?
Shruti, I think you are already there for us to hire you. Huh? So much of detailing you have got about IFP. I am so proud of you. Good. So yeah, we are the pioneers and we are the ones who are very, very superior to our technology, right? In Pune, we are coming with a factory. We are launching a refrigerator, right? And we are creating a factory in Rajnandgaon. So we'll be very much in close to your institute, which is a 39-acre factory that we're creating. In IFB, we try to see, like, see, I'll tell you, in this washing machine, no, we try to reach out to those ladies, of all those grandmoms of the house. There are videos where they have reached out to the grandmoms of the house or the ladies of the house or the maids of the house to try and figure out what is that they are not liking or what is that they need. And based on that need, we try to create our inputs. And that is what makes us more close to the customer in terms of the requirements. So if you see in microwave oven today, we know all of you are walking, the husband and wife both are walking. Do they need a traditional microwave today? No. So today we have got micro ovens, which just press a button and then press one more button. Third button, your entire food has been cooked. So it can be anything that you want to have. So that's the level of AI that has gone into this. If I talk about my dryer, see, a lot of people have learned a lot of things out of this pandemic. We what do our grandparents say? धूप में आप कपड़ा सुखाओ तो सारे जर्म्स खत्म हो जाते हैं करेक्ट ना बट व्हाट इज नाउ द रियलिटी कि आप बाहर मत जाइए मास्क बिना पहने बिकॉज देयर लॉट ऑफ जर्म्स आउटसाइड देयर बी दोस कोरोना वायरसेस मूविंग अराउंड राइट डू यू वांट सपोजिंगली नो समबडी गेट्स मैरिड हैज गॉट अ किड डू यू वांट टू पुट दैट क्लोथ आउटसाइड टू गेट दैट सन रेज एंड नो गेट दोस व्हाटएवर आवर ग्रैंडमॉम टोल्ड और यू यूज अ ड्रायर which gives you a steam wash, which gives you a steam cleaning, drying, and your clothes get the same sun rays heat and makes your clothes soft, makes your clothes germ-free, and you are not actually exposing it. So that's how we are trying to innovate ourselves. So we are very, very strong in innovation. And if you look at our products, we don't advertise much. We don't really communicate through our paper ads and TV ads. You don't have seen much of TV ads. We center around the ladies of the house. Because all our products are largely for kitchen and home. And we really communicate with our people to try and understand what is their need. And that's how we have launched today. We have got a micro oven, which are called a air fry, inbuilt micro ovens. You don't need air fryer. Because everybody knows health, they don't want to fry anything. So we have given an oil-free micro oven, which is a new trend that has come up. So that's how we try to keep ourselves ready with whatever new innovation needs to be done. And we've got a fantastic team who are based out of Goa and they really work 24 hours to keep creating a lot of values.
Right, sir. So the next question is from one of our faculty members, Professor Girish Ketkar, and he is asking, festival season has begun. E-commerce companies like Amazon and Flipkart have begun announcing huge discounts on electronic goods. But physical retail chains like Croma or Vijay Sales can't match these discounts. So they lose customers to e-commerce companies. Doesn't this create discontentment among physical channels? And as a major brand in consumer electronics, how do you manage the conflict between physical and electronic channels?
Wow. I think if I hand over my phone to GK sir and there is a WhatsApp group, by now I've not seen for last 1 hour, there would have been some 100 messages on this discounting by the channel. So anyway, so it's a very big subject. I'll try to summarize as much as possible. See, first, we need to understand, sir, in today's time, there are three large channels, right? One we called in our consumer electronics or in FMCG, we called e-commerce. Then there's something called large format, that is your Vijay Sales, Reliance, Croma, all those original players, right? Like in Pune, you've got Praveen and all those people. And then you've got your MBOs, we call multi-brand outlets, like the small outlet in around when you go to the market, right? And there's something called rural distribution market, which are basically tier two, tier three. All these four are very, very important for us to have to ensure that we are available and visible across the channel, across the market, right? E-com, if you are not there, boss, you are gone. Because today, if I sell 100 machines, 25 machines sales from e-com. And there is zero logistic cost for me because I don't have to make this stock reach to the consumer house. Right, I don't have to really worry about their payment because e-com the financials are very simple, but your payouts are very high. If you move your 25% to 40%, trust me, your branch will get shut because you'll not make money. Right, then comes Vijay Sales, and because there are customers who don't believe in e-com, but they do believe in e-com price, but they want to come and touch and feel and then try to take that advantage of understanding the channel and then talking to the promoter, like I told about Archana ji going and buying from me. So she really values the interaction and more learning from the communication, right? This also is very, very important. So GK sir, in today's time, Vijay Sales and all these big guys, Reliance, Croma, are equally a big pain as the e-com are. Now, you'll see it's a very dirty game being played by both these guys. E-com has allowed Vijay Sales and all these Chromas and all to sell in their platform also. And they have got their own online platform also, right? Both the people are trying to match each other every day morning. And the biggest losers are the small stores, which you have built over the last 25 years. Now, our issue is to manage these small stores. So what we do, e-com and Vijay Sales is not a problem. Here we try to manage the discount. Don't, please don't discount. We have to go back and tell them, please reduce your discount. You'll find, suppose you get 30% discount on micro oven. After half an hour, you go and see in Vijay Sales, it would have come down to 25% because somebody has spoken to Vijay Sales to bring it down. So those controls are there in place. There's not about to worry about our payouts, their retentions, because they're making money. Issue is the other part, which is my smaller guys and my multi-brand outlets. So now we tell them that there will be a war in the market because we cannot ignore, no company can ignore these two channels. Now, I can't make these guys die because they also look forward to sales, right? And there are customers who are willing to go to these small guys. Everybody can't go to Vijay Sales, right? They go to the small guys. We contribute 48% sales from these small guys. Here, my cost of sale is the cheapest. My cost of sale in Vijay Sales is 30%, here it is 22%. So I really make that margin. I need to have that margin to equate the entire cost. Here, for those 5 days, 10 days, we try to give them a support. If any customer comes, says that online this price is available and I can't give it, please give it to the customer, keep a screenshot, give it to us, we'll pay you back the money. So we are trying to build trust of these guys, saying that, boss, we cannot ignore Vijay Sales, we cannot ignore Reliance, we cannot ignore e-com. So here, my cost of sales goes up for 5 days, but I do a disruption in terms of sales. If I don't do it, my market share is gone. So could I answer you, sir?
Yes, I think that was a very comprehensive answer.
Yeah, this is a lot more complicated than what I could say, you guys. But good that such questions are coming up. Huh?
Sir, we'll take the last one. And this one says, this is again from Avik. And he's asking, how zero compromise philosophy helps you in getting success in the VUCA world?
VUCA. Come again, for... I just lost you in that. I think I lost the audio.
Sir. I'll repeat, sir. It says, how zero compromise philosophy helps you in getting success in the VUCA world? Volatile, uncertain, okay. Complex, ambiguous.
Okay, good. So see, I'll tell you. Now, let me take an example. Without taking an example, I'll not be able to explain this. Let me talk about AC, right? AC is where we talk about zero compromise. IFB is a brand which knows that they're technically very superior. Superior, right? We know our products are technically superior. We can beat anybody hands on, but I need to communicate. So what I've done in IAP, you'll find there is a 10 years warranty of my equip, my spare parts being available to any consumer who buys today. That means if you buy a machine, the part, every component of that machine, I ensure that I keep stock of the spares for 10 years. So first, zero compromise, which gets into the head of the customer, is that a lot of time you would have gone to buy some TV or something, then you don't know what is the kind of service backup, and then you say, yaar, forget it, yaar. Usko maalum nahi, service center kab tak chalega. And then you go back to the same brand that you possibly don't want to buy, but you are still buying it because you know that you will have this company there to stay, because they are there for last 20 years, right? See, here we are getting into the customer's mind saying, sir, don't worry, madam, don't worry. Every component of the product that you have bought will be there with our warehouse for 10 years. 10 years is a big, long commitment by a company to the consumer in today's electronics world, right? And for giving the statement, LGs and Samsung of the world has to really first create a product which will have that kind of tenacity to continue for 10 years and above. Also ensure the stocks are there. If we are one company which makes our own byproducts also. We make our own small components also. I don't import. We don't take it from the vendors. So for me to make my product and keep my spare parts with me is far, far easier than for any other competitor, right? Because most of the time they outsource this to the vendors, right? Number two, if you look at our AC, sorry, that's number two important thing is we talk about 4-year warranty. No company gives you a 4-year warranty in a washing machine. You can go and check it out today. They talk about 2 years, 3 years, 4-year complete warranty. This again is talking about zero compromise. You don't have to worry, madam. You buy the machine and you be free. You don't have to worry about your warranty also. Each year warranty, extended warranty costs you 2,000 rupees. When you buy a machine, people say, are LG ka to sir, 2,000 pe sasta hai, 18,000 milta, aapka to 20,000 ka hai. Then our people struggle to say, then our people come and say, sir, after 2 years, you have to buy a warranty, extended warranty, right? Every warranty costs you 2,000 rupees. I'm giving you 4 years warranty. That means 2 years additional warranty is free to you. And what is it? It's showing you that you are saving money in case you need those warranty. You have to get the warranty. Second, I'm telling you that 4 years you don't have to worry because I don't want to spend my money. No, they know very smartly that a company has 4 years kuch hoga nahi. But that's a big statement. 4 years mera machine kuch hoga nahi is a big statement by the company. Again, here comes the zero compromise. Right? We don't compromise on the technology. Third, is your 10 years motor warranty we have launched recently last month? Was no company gives you a 10 years motor warranty, but trust me, no motor goes wrong. But standing up and saying that I will give you a 10 years warranty on a motor needs a lot of conviction, right? So here we come with the philosophy where we want to make, because as I told you, we don't advertise. For us, customer who is using IAP is my brand ambassador, right? Because we have got testimonials where customer using for 12 years, their kids have got married, they've got the grandchildren and the machine is still running. So we work on that zero compromise philosophy. We try to get into the nitty gritty of what the customer wants. To tell you, Bombay, a outdoor AC. We have went to the detailing that outdoor AC because the space of constraint of the space. Customer don't buy a big bulky outdoor unit. If it is a 10 inch outdoor unit, no, they don't buy it. We've ensured that Bombay, every outdoor unit is 9 inches so that a customer who buys can fit it there. So these are all zero compromise. We don't want to compromise where customers to go and just do some digging and try to put that AC inside. So that's what we are good at. And we are technically very superior. And we are a company, Indian company. We are very proud that this company is irrespective of not being on the media, not being in the TV medium or through the paper ads, still gives a run to LGs and Samsung of the world, the Koreans. We today still demand a 45% market share in the market, in such competitive market, because of this philosophy of zero compromise. And talking to the customer doesn't allow customer to talk to the competition. I hope I could answer.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for being so patient and answering all the queries of the students and the faculty. Thank you so much. I'll hand it back to the compares now.
Okay. I hope I could add value, and I'd love to come and meet you guys whenever you guys want me. I keep going to Pune so I can drop in whenever you guys want me.
Definitely, sir. That's a promise we'll take from you, that whenever possible, do visit us on campus.
Please.
Yeah, most welcome, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. May I now request student manager Agdas to deliver the vote of thanks.
Hi, Agdas Sheikh, on the behalf of our SBUP, holiday directors, faculty members, and my fellow student managers, extend a deep gratitude to our honorable guest, Mr. Sambit Panda sir, who has taken out his valuable time from his busy schedule and honored us with his presence to interact with all of us today. Some key learnings from the sessions are: where you can't think is the point where you really start thinking. Ambitious must be greater than the sources. Sir, you explained the difference between important and urgent with a very amazing example. We need to have our priority list updated with the time management. Stress management is the key to success. Sir, we thank you for being with us, and it has been a privilege listening to you. We have gained a lot from you, sir, and we look forward for many more interactions with you off as well as on campus. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and wish you all the best, guys. Have a rocking career ahead, and thank you all the mentors. I'd love to come and learn something from you guys also, because you guys are the pillars of all this. No, the fraternity that you are creating, who are going to, and we have got in our company, we've got a lot many people from Balaji. In fact, I am blessed to work with my Pune PM is, I think, Balaji Passout. My marketing head is Balaji Passout. When she heard about it, I spoke to Archana ji. She was so happy. She told me, sir, can I put it on my Facebook and Instagram? I'm like, don't do it, yeah. Don't just hold on, because I don't know whether they put it anything on the social media. Don't do it. So we are blessed to work with a few of your alumni, and they are the rock stars, and they are there gathering all those golden dust. They are there for 8 years with the company. So that's very important for us to have those first 7-8 years of career in one company and learn and move ahead. Thank you very much, everybody. All the best. Thank you,
sir. Just request you to stay on for a minute more, sir. And very reassuring to know that our students are doing so very well. Very reassuring. So just a minute longer, sir.
They're really doing well.
Thank you, Agdas. I now request Professor Vikas Nam Joshi, Deputy Director, BIMM, to present a token of gratitude to our guest, Sambit Panda, sir.
Sambit, sir, good morning. And first of all, thank you very much for a wonderful session. Sir, I can sum up your session in 3 words. Your session was very easy to relate, highly practical and relevant to the budding management graduates. Sir, I'm sure they have absorbed a lot of things from your session. Sir, on behalf of all the students, my colleagues, we have a small token of gratitude to you, sir. This is a small book titled Rethink.
Thank you.
Leading Voices on Life After Crisis. We will courier it to you, sir. And we are thankful to you for your gracious presence. Looking forward to you on the campus, sir. Thank you. And namaste to you, sir.
Thank you so very much. Thank you.
Namaste,
thank you, sir. Yeah. Namaste. Thank you. All the best, guys.
Thank you, sir.
Can I log off? It's okay. Some meetings off.
Sir, if you wish, you can stay. But your path is now.
Okay, then I possibly put my video off. I just need to attend some mails and then clear.
Sure, sir. Up to you, sir. The same link will work. Thank you, sir. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.